Hi everyone, and welcome to part two of Orchestrating Like Joe Hisaishi. I'll be looking at more examples from the symphonic suite to Spirited Away, specifically at how the composer orchestrated melodies from that piece. After each excerpt, I'll try orchestrating my own themes in a similar way, and as always, you can get all of the project files from my orchestrations in this video on my Patreon page, so check that out if you're interested. For this video, I thought it might be interesting to look at just one theme from Spirited Away and see how Hisaishi changes the orchestration of that theme throughout. The theme is called Reprise, and it's first presented in a solo oboe with harp and string accompaniments. So how is this passage constructed? The oboe is alone on the melody, and it occupies exactly an octave in register between G4 and G5. That's an important thing to note here, because every instrument has a different timbre and presence at different parts of its range. So part of what makes this orchestration sound the way it does is its registral placement in relation to the accompaniment, and how the melody and accompaniment are therefore balanced. Underneath the melody, we have a harp eighth note part that is playing the bass notes on the downbeat, and then arpeggios that fit the chord, which, by the way, are triads with some sevenths and ninths added in. Overlapping with the harp are the string sustains, playing notes of the harmony, and like I said, staying registrally underneath the solo oboe. Finally, in the last measure here, there is a brief celeste and glockenspiel part that helps the music transition into the next phrase. So overall, this is very simple. In the very next phrase, Hisaishi adds a clarinet and a flute up the octave to that oboe melody. And a few measures later, he adds a bassoon an octave below. All of these winds are solo. With those additions, he can afford to make the string parts a bit more active, although they aren't that much higher in register. And he brings in bass pizzicatos on the downbeats. Alright, so how can I take that basic orchestration concept and apply it to my theme, almost like a template or a formula? My theme here doesn't really sound anything like Reprise from Spirited Away. If you recall, I was modeling this one more on the Nausicaa main theme. So this is in 4-4 time, whereas Reprise has a very clear 3-4 pulse. Mine is in a minor key, and Reprise is in major. So other than the fact that my theme here is just melody and chords, and the fact that I used a very Hisaishi-like chord progression, there's really not a lot similar to that Spirited Away cue. But that's okay, I can still apply a similar orchestration, it'll just sound a bit different. One of the most important things here to keep in mind when giving a melody like this to a solo woodwind is the range of notes and the tessitura, which means where the notes mostly lie within that instrument's range. The tessitura will determine the overall timbral quality of the melody, and the total range will determine if the melody is even possible on that instrument. In some cases, you might have to bump a small section of notes up the octave. The first phrase of the Reprise melody lies between F sharp 4 to G5, so the tessitura is mostly within the treble clef staff. That's a perfect register for oboe. It avoids the lower notes that have a darker, louder sound, and it avoids the high notes that have a thinner timbre. Not that you always have to avoid those parts of the oboe, they're just more difficult to work with and don't have as consistent of dynamics. My theme has a slightly wider range, still within the playable oboe range, but it goes a bit lower to some of those darker, louder notes. So I have four options at this point. One, I could not worry about it and just let the oboe play the melody as is. Perhaps just make a note of this moment when I add accompanying parts. Two, I could bump this part of the melody up the octave or recompose it in some way. Bumping these four notes up the octave means that the lower range of the melody is now a third higher than before, which probably works better for the oboe. However, I'm not sure I like the melody jumping up right here. The whole melodic shape was pointing downwards from measure 7 on. So do I really want the sudden jump? Perhaps a better idea would be to recompose these last four notes. Now I'm avoiding the low C on the oboe, but still maintaining the lower tessitura for this last measure, without making the melody all that different sounding. I'll play both in the oboe in just a moment, but there's also a third option. I could transpose the whole piece to a new key, which would be a more drastic change, of course, but it might work in some cases. The problem here is that this melody has a fairly wide range, so if I transpose it up to avoid really low notes, then, well, I'll be potentially getting into problem notes on the high end. The oboe timbre starts to thin out and sound a bit different when you get around C6, that's the C above the treble clef staff, so the melody will take on a slightly different quality if the tessitura shifts up by more than just a note or two. And of course, a fourth option would be to change the instrument from oboe to something else, but for the sake of this video, I'd really like to stick to Hisaishi's orchestration configuration as much as possible, so I'm going to stick with oboe. So here's what I first came up with. The oboe melody is unaltered here, the harp has constant eighth note arpeggios, and the strings are playing soft sustains underneath that oboe melody. Because the oboe tessitura is higher in my theme than in the Hisaishi, there will be more registral separation between melody and accompaniment, at least initially. As the oboe melody descends into the lower part of that instrument's range, I make sure to keep the violins below the oboe, or texturally, at least out of the way. Here's what this sounds like. If I change the last four notes, I can avoid that low C in the oboe. Honestly, I probably would just keep it as is, but I'll play this for measure 7 here. Mentioned the possibility of transposing this melody up, and how the oboe timbre would start to sound very differently with a higher tessitura. To demonstrate, I've transposed up a fifth to G minor. This is a fairly large transposition, you wouldn't necessarily want to move this far, but this example shows off that really high oboe timbre. To me, the oboe up here has a much more sorrowful sound, and in certain circumstances this might work really well. By the way, this is likely much more difficult to perform for the oboist, so that's something to keep in mind if you're working with live musicians. So in the next phrase of Reprise, if you recall, Hisaishi added a flute up the octave, a clarinet in unison on the melody, and a bassoon down the octave several measures in. I'll do the same with my theme. In the original key of C minor, this is what I get. Notice the flute register is right up at the top of its range, same with bassoon when it enters. This could be problematic because I want to maintain a soft dynamic overall, and flute way up there is naturally quite a bit louder. Before I play this version, I'll demonstrate again in G minor, which will more closely match Hisaishi's registers. Now the flute is in a more comfortable range and can more easily blend with the oboe and clarinet below. right, so back to C minor. I'll play this one now, but keep in mind that these sample libraries were designed to sound as pristine as possible. And sometimes with that, you get an unrealistic balance in the extreme parts of the register. So the really high flute part won't stand out as much in this mockup as it probably would in reality. If I wanted to keep this in the key of C minor with the instrumentation roughly the same, I might try bumping the flute down the octave and then adding in a piccolo at that high octave. I could then remove clarinet, and instead of bassoon, I might consider adding in an English horn in its place. I'm just looking for instruments that will fit the register and will blend well together, but I don't want to really add any instruments without taking some away. Here's what this sounds like. Moving on, here's another orchestration within Hisaishi's Reprise theme. In these eight measures, there are five things happening. First, Hisaishi places the melody in the violins 1, 2, and celli, each in their own octave. The first violins sit mostly above the treble clef staff, the seconds within the staff, and the celli in the tenor range, which is between the top portion of the bass clef staff and the bottom half of the treble clef staff. Then there are the bass notes found in the harp, sustaining bassoons, staccato tuba, and pizzicato basses down the octave. I'm including the second bassoon part in this group as well because even though it's a harmonization of the bass notes, it's rhythmically aligned. Then there's this middle register horn material that's both harmonic and a bit rhythmic, but overall a background part. Then there's a viola, clarinet, and harp background arpeggiated part, sandwiched registrally between second violins and celli, basically occupying the same range as the horns, but much more rhythmically separate. And lastly, there's a bit of counter material in the upper winds, specifically piccolo, two flutes, two oboes, and an English horn joins in halfway through. There's quite a bit happening here, but I'll see if I can create a similar texture in my theme. Even if I apply the same basic formula, my version will undoubtedly sound very different because, again, the music is very different. If my theme itself sounded almost identical, and then I applied that same orchestration, of course I'd get something that sounded basically the same, but guess what? Then I'd be plagiarizing. It's okay to be inspired by a composer's sound or harmonies, but you have to remember to make it your own. Alright, so I'll place the melody in violins and celli in three separate octaves. I notice right away that, as was the case before, my theme in C minor positions these instruments in a lower overall tessitura than the Hisaishi piece. That will certainly affect the overall sound and balance. I could bump all of this up the octave, but then we're up there pretty high in the violins. It could work well for a climactic moment perhaps, but that's really not what I'm going for here. And of course, if I choose a different key, let's say G minor again, the tessitura matches Hisaishi's more closely, which will make balancing this against the rest of the orchestral texture much easier. So I'm going to choose this because I think it'll work a lot better. Now I'll fill in the bass range with bassoon, harp, bass pizzicatos, and tuba. Hisaishi used tuba staccatos on the downbeat. I think that worked well in the faster 3-4 time, but it might sound a bit out of place in a slower 4-4, which is what my piece here is, so I'll have tuba play short notes with tenutos instead of staccatos. And second bassoons, plus the top note of the harp, will be harmonizing mostly at the fifth. So next I'll add a divisi viola part, doubled in clarinets, and also in the right hand of the harp. Because the range of this part overlaps with the melody in the cello octave, I had to make sure that there were no clashing notes, which could have easily occurred in moments like this, where the melody has passing tones leading into the next measure. So in the specific moment or eighth note where those passing tones occur, I have to make sure that the viola and clarinet part harmonizes well with those passing tones. But other than those moments, this arpeggiated part is mostly just chord tones. Next, we have four horns playing chords in a similar register to the arpeggios. And lastly, the high woodwind counter material. Like the arpeggios, I had to make sure that I'm not stepping on the melody in any way or creating momentary clashes. I tried to make the counter material most active when the melody is sustaining a longer note. And in terms of voicing these chords, I followed the same basic configuration as Hisaishi. Two flutes mostly harmonizing in thirds or sixths, then oboes doubling flutes, plus a piccolo an octave above second flute. Halfway through, the English horn enters an octave below the first oboe. Putting this all together, here's what this sounds like. Okay, moving on, I want to look at two more textures in Hisaishi's Reprise theme. This particular passage has woodwinds on the melody in three octaves, with violas on the middle octave, then harp and violin on arpeggiated eighth notes. Horns in a similar role to before, just adding some middle register harmonic support, then also a trumpet with a counterline registerly above the first horn part. This new line is rhythmically and melodically quite the contrast to the main melody. And finally, celli, contrabassoon, pizzicato basses, and tuba are on the bass notes. There are definitely some similarities to the last texture I looked at, and in some cases, he's just swapped parts or roles between instrument groups. Here's what this sounds like. So instead of the A section, I decided to apply this orchestration concept to the B section of my theme for a change. Here are the instruments on the melody, two flutes with piccolo joining in halfway through, two oboes an octave lower, with an English horn moving to the lower octave when it can, two clarinets and violas on that middle octave as well, and then a bass clarinet and two bassoons in the lowest octave. On the backgrounds, following Hisaishi's textures, I have horns on rhythmic mid-register chords, a solo trumpet counterline above the horns, arpeggiated violins, and then contrabassoon, tuba, celli, and pizzicato basses on the bass notes. All right, putting this all together, here's what it sounds like. Alright, so the last texture I'll look at from Hisaishi's Reprise, violins, violas, celli, English horn, and piccolo are on the melody, spanning four octaves this time. Then the rest of the upper winds are on counter material, similar to what we've seen before from them. Then a staccato rhythmic horn texture, once again in the same register as before, plus a full brass section this time on backgrounds that includes three trumpets, four trombones, and a tuba. And of course, bassoons and basses playing those downbeat low bass notes again. Actually, they're playing alongside bass trombone and tuba. All right, just to wrap this video up, I decided to have fun with this one. I actually converted my theme to a 3/4 meter. I thought this particular part of the theme, the end of the B section, would work well in 3. I've once again modeled my textures on Hisaishi's with the melody in violins, violas, celli, and piccolo, plus an upper woodwind counterpart, a full brass section playing mostly staccatos in the background, and bassoons and basses playing bass notes. Here's what this sounds like. Alright, so that's it for this one. Thanks so much for watching, and like I said earlier, you can grab the MIDI files, Music XML files, Dorico, Cubase, and Studio One files, as well as the audio stems for all of my orchestrations in this video on my Patreon page. There's a link to that below. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.